back in the days, the engineer had final say on the design of the car. It wasn't marketing, it wasn't sales. So when they were given a task to produce a car that had to carry four people, travel medium distances, and consume less gas, they came up with the Citroën 2CV. And it has everything that was needed and nothing else. Live in France, but I wanted to bring a piece of the French car history with me. This car was a true bon fine, one owner in a town called Tours in France, purchased in 1961 by a baker who kept it all his life. I love the patina, I love the colors, I love that the seafoam green, vert en brun, as it is in France, has weathered the way it has weathered. It has plenty of surface rust, and it gives her just tons of character, and I have no intention of changing that. She's 1961, she drives every day. I will take this car cross country tomorrow in the state that she is, and she will be fine. The simplicity in engineering makes this car. Air-cooled two-cylinder, has no belts whatsoever. The oil cooler fan is directly onto the crankshaft. The whole entire car is but 1,100 pounds. All the body panels are stamped steel. The 2CV doesn't have a gas gauge. It has a leather strip that is graduated from 0 to 25 liters. You remove it from the gas tank, you read where you are, and you put it back in. So it's a little quirks, but the simplicity makes this car really brilliant. This little engine produces about 23 horsepower. It's a gearbox with three gears and an overdrive. My model has a centrifuge clutch. When you're stopped, you don't have to have the clutch engaged. To shift in second, third, and overdrive, you use the clutch. The way the gears function, the way it's completely imprecise, the way you have to learn that pattern or lack thereof to be able to make it shift is what makes it ironically really enjoyable. You have the windows open, you have the top rolled back, and you sort of don't care if it goes fast or not, because at the end of the day it's moving forward, that's what matters. There's this espresso truck in town, a Citroën as well. It sits in various spots in the city, and so when I drive, I try to find it. Stop by and get an espresso, it always makes, again, it makes people laugh because they see the truck and then they see my car. And it's just really a fun little outing to try to scout for that truck and then find it and just get an espresso and then be on my way. I'm not quite sure where I'm going to go. Just go out and I drive. I have a couple of routes that I like to take. It's not a very well insulated car, so I try to go early in the morning when we can roll down the top. Usually my outings are 30 minutes, 45 minutes, an hour. If I take the dog, we'll stop somewhere, we'll just play fetch. The dog rides next to me and he just enjoys it. He is a little bit of an attraction of his own. That's what makes it fun. When you drive a special car, it doesn't matter if it brings you from point A to point B, is what it makes you feel that matters. For me, this car is the feeling that I am driving a piece of French heritage. So I'm very proud to drive this car. It's slower than anything else on the road at any given time. Yet, nobody honks at me. Nobody loses their patience when they see me, when they drive behind me. People high five, the thumbs up, adults, 60 years old, 80 years old, it doesn't matter. People are not going to be aggravated. They're going to smile. It makes me smile, it relaxes me, even though sometimes it's not that easy to drive it. I just enjoy the whole process of driving this car. Mon nom est Sam Prokop, et c'est pour ça que je conduis.